I'd like to think that I've distanced myself from that. It is ultimately a trivial and non-productive way for one to spend one's time here in the multiverse. There's much more to life, wouldn't you agree? Perhaps so. Can I ask you another question? Okay. We'll ask quite a bit of her. Can you tell me about the Sensate? Yeah, we know what they are. Devoted to experience, without sensation, we are blinded to much of the multiverse. Thus, Sensates seek to experience as much as possible. When all is experience, then the truth of the multiverse shall reveal itself. Her questions, questions, questions. She won't join now, that I know, but I'm not sure what I need to do to get her to join. Perhaps you can help me, can you? What kind of help are you looking for? I seem to have lost my memories. In doing so, I've lost myself. You have been stricken with amnesia, Fall of Grace looks pained. How terrible! Do you have any idea how it happened? Not really, at least not that I can remember. I woke up on a slab in the mortuary, and everything before that is black. I woke in the mortuary. I think the dustman took me for being dead, or I was dead, or something. All I know is that I regenerate my wounds quickly. I could be immortal, but I don't even know that for sure. Fall from Grace seems to be appraising you with a renewed interest. Those scars on your body, he reaches out a hand as if to touch you, yeah? Yes. Fall from Grace drags her fingers across your chest slightly, tracing the edges of your scars, following the curves where they blend into some of your tattoos. She seems fascinated. These scars do look as if they would have taken several lifetimes to accumulate. Yeah, they certainly do, though some are more recent. Fall from Grace steps back. Some of those wounds would have been fatal to a normal man. She taps her chin, thinking, what do you intend to do now? Yeah, that's a... Again, we have some options. Do nothing. Don't really know. Start searching for clues to who I am, what happened to me. Okay, I need to get my memories back and my life back. I tend to scour the planes and search inside myself, and until I piece together who I am and what brought me to this state. All from Grace is still thinking, her fingers tapping on her chin. I must say, I've never met a man who had lost himself in the literal sense. She raises an eyebrow. Forgive me, but your condition is intriguing. Yeah. It is that. Fall from Grace nods. If it will help, you are welcome to tour the brothel. Several of our students are well versed in the verbal art. Perhaps some of them will be able to rekindle your memories. Yeah, I may do that.
Updated questions, my journal.
Questions, questions. Have you heard of the Night Hag Rabble? I'm familiar with the name. Rumors cluster thickly about that name, and most tend to discount her as a myth. But I suspect that she did exist, that she made quite an impression in the cage during her stay here. She looks puzzled. Why do you ask? I intend to seek her out. Grace raises an eyebrow. Truly? I find myself compelled to ask why. Yeah, I need information that she has. Is this information available from no one else? I suspect only Ravel possessed the knowledge I need.
Updated my journal.
Grace rests her hand lightly on your arm. Consider this. If Ravel does indeed exist, then she is extremely powerful and cunning. If a fraction of the stories of her activities are true, then she is a creature that has discovered new meanings of evil. To search for her is not a quest to be undertaken lightly. Yeah, I realize that. Do you know anything else about Ravel? She was said to be one of the hags of the Grey Waste, and she was believed to possess power and cunning far beyond those of her sisters. She came to Sichel long ago, and in addition to the evil she committed during her stay, rumor has it that her actions threatened the cage itself. Now she primarily exists only as fiction, a figure in children's stories. Grace pauses. I imagine the Lady of Pain dealt with her as all threats to Sigil are dealt with. How?
Updated my journal.
Gravel was most likely sent to a maze, one of the lady's prisons. Okay, mazes. What are those?
Updated my journal.
Grace glances her hands, claps. What? Grace places her hands together, thumb and finger touching, forming a rough circle. The lady is said to have the power to take pieces of sigil. You watch in surprise as a ghostly image of Grace's little finger pulls itself from the hand and floats into the air, curling into a small circle, and makes a maze. Okay, go on. The small ghostly circle floats in the air, then begins slowly rotating. The piece of sigil she takes holds the prisoner. There's no escaping being mazed. It can happen at any time while walking down the street through a door. She claps her hands, and then you are somewhere else. Inside the ghostly circle, you can suddenly see a flicker of movement, like someone walking inside. Go on. Grace continues, a tiny ghost mage reflected in her eyes. It is said that there is a portal that leads out of each maze, but they are difficult to find, perhaps they are left in to give prisoner hope, perhaps they are left in to torture the prisoner. The ghostly maze dissolves, perhaps it is both. See, can you tell more about this plane that Rivel is from, the Grave Waste? A blighted plane that lies effectively between Beator and Abyss is frequently a battleground in the Blood War. Is there anyone else who might know about her? Someone in the Festhall may know more of her.
Updated my journal.
Yeah, I think I'll ask that. Would you like to join me in our travels? She will say no. Anna stiffens, then starts muttering under her breath. Who's to say she'll be coming with us? We don't need the likes of her, shows we don't. Bar that, fiendling, Morte clicks his teeth together. I'm all for the succubus coming with us. Powers know you're about as fun as passing a caltrop through your bowels. Eat best last year, bone box, Carl, or I'll rattle you so hard you'll be picking your teeth off the spire. Travel with you? Wolfram Grey smiles slightly. She seems to be ignoring your companions. That's rather forward of you. I'd rather be honest with my intentions. You seem extremely pleasant and well-versed in the ways of the plains. A companion with that kind of knowledge would be welcome. Yeah, also, you are a sensei. Surely there must be a limit to how much you can learn here. I think you would be surprised. If you want me to accompany you on your travels, I need a far more compelling reason than that. Okay, you mean you wouldn't be interested in traveling with an immortal amnesiac who is searching the plains for himself? Oh, I would be extremely interested. She smiles slightly. Such a suggestion is intriguing, make no mistake about that. Then you would like to travel with me? If you wish me to, then there is something you must do for me. There are 10 students in this establishment. I would like you to speak to all of them, then return to me with your thoughts. Then we shall see if we travel together or not. Yeah, we'll speak to them then.
Updated my journal.
Okay, now we know what we must do. I'm gonna save here because I don't want to go through the discussions again. As enjoyable as they are on the first time, these can get very tedious if you have to redo things.
Feeling, I have to ask, where did you get that accent?
Accent? What are you on about?
Never mind.